Welcome my cool cats and kittens. Just got my pants on today. Just gonna wait for everyone to join. If you didn't see my post, you need a small cushion or a small towel rolled up, so I'll show you what I mean. Maybe like one from the couch. We don't have very good ones here, but it might even be smaller than this, like a little cushion from your bed or something. Or otherwise you can just get a towel, roll it up, and we're just gonna use it between the legs. So either option is fine. So grab those now if you don't already have them. And otherwise you just need your mat or some space and a towel on the ground if you don't have a mat. Hoping to get some people on the screen today. Maybe Ben will make his debut. He is to the side, but we're hoping to get him into the frame. And we'll just get started in about 2 more minutes. Short Sosh, what you need is just a towel rolled up, or if you've got a little pillow in your hotel room, like this, just a small pillow. It's just gonna be used between our legs. So a small pillow or a towel and just roll it up does the same thing. So we're gonna be working the inner thighs and the side body today, but it will be still a full body workout. Glad that you're a duck, David. Okay, hi Nettie. Hi Liv. We'll just wait 2 more minutes. Hi Sha, hi Leo. Hi Linda. All right, 1 more minute and we'll get started. So grab that towel or that cushion if you don't already have it. By the way, we're listening to Beyonce all day today, or all for the 40 minutes. So if you don't like Beyonce, sorry. Annie says hi. Hi, Mum. You told me to do not much knee stuff. Cannot be promised. Sha, back for more. Love it. All right, guys. Let's get started. We're going to start standing up. Okay, so just come to your mat. Hopefully you can all hear me and the music okay. Just comment if the music gets too loud. Okay, we're just gonna start by rolling down through the spine. Chin comes down into your chest, rolling through the spine. Bone by bone, all the way down to the mat. Try to do this without bending your knees, but if you need to bend your knees, take that option. Bring your hands down to the ground or as close as you can get to it. Release any tension from the wrists, taking a roll through the wrists and a roll through the shoulders. Then re-step yourselves all the way up, pulling into the belly button, lower back, mid back, upper spine, shoulders rolling back. 1 more time, chin comes down to your chest, rolling through the spine, lowering down vertebra by vertebra. Really slow through this if you can. Again, releasing any tension from your shoulders. You need to take a bend into each knee. And then carefully re-step your spine up, bone by bone, all the way up to a standing position. Roll those shoulders back. All right, let's get started. Starting with some squats just to warm up. Your hands are just gonna come out into prayer in front of you. Sinking the bum back, let's just take 10 here. Really slow, sinking that bum back, inhaling through your nose, and exhaling through your mouth. 5 more, thinking about those knees tracking over your middle toes. Really sink the weight back into your heel, last 2. Last 1, this time you're gonna come down, pulse for 3, 1, 2, 3 and stand. Coming down, 3, 2, 1 and stand. Keep moving through this one. three pulses at the bottom and standing. Keep breathing in through your nose, out through your mouth. Nice, keep moving here. Hi, Harry. Five more. Last three, releasing that weight back. Try to lift your toes up slightly as you squat down. Last two. Burning off those Easter eggs. Last one, we're gonna come all the way down and hold after those pulses. Just holding here. Hands come behind the head. Try to keep your body nice and upright. Your left hand's gonna reach down, touch your pinky, top. Comes back behind your head, other side. So it's a little bit of a side hinge where we hold into that squat position. You should be feeling quite a burn. Final set of the lunges. Sorry, squats. Five more. Breathing here. Can you sink any lower? Four. Control breath. Three. Last two. And one. Carefully stand all the way up. Shake it out. You should be feeling warm in those legs now. All right, you're gonna grab that towel or the cushion. Place it in between your legs. So upper thigh. Yeah, so your inner thigh area just above your knee. Cool. Holding it there, you're gonna come onto your tiptoes. I'm just gonna warm up the inner thighs here and into the legs a bit more. Hands are gonna come out in front of you. And if at any point you need to lower the heels, do so. We're going to sink back into a squat. Hold. Hands are going to come down to the mat as you straighten your legs out. Try to keep the heels lifted. You then raise your hands up in front of you again as you sink your bum back into a squat. Okay. So we lower the hands, straighten the legs, sink back, hands come up. Hands to mat. Legs straighten, sink the bum back as your hands come up. Try to do this whole thing with your heels lifted. Straighten the legs. Nice, keep breathing. Squeeze that cushion or that towel. Two more. Take this in your own time. Use your breath to help you. Last one, come into that little squat. Arms come out in front of you. Can you sink any lower? Lift those heels. Four. Three, two, and one. Nice, shake it out, place that to the side. Let's warm up those glutes a little bit more. Left foot is gonna come in front, right foot is gonna come back. You guys have done this before, we're just gonna warm up those glutes before we move into the rest of the body. Sink down into a lunge, and lift. So left foot is forward, right foot is back. We're just lowering and lifting. Let's just take six here. Slow down that breath. Last two. And one. All right. Hinge the body forward. All of your weight is in your left heel. Right toes back. Take a little bit of sink into that left knee. Eye gaze is forward ahead of you. Neck is in line with that back leg. From here, I just want you to tap forward and tap back. Just four here. If you want to make this harder for the sequence, bring your hands out in line with your ears. So this is option number one. Now we're moving into option number two. Come back to that one if you need to. Leg comes up nice and high. You drive it back. Comes in. And releases out. So this one really working into the balance now. Take that tap at the back if you need to. We're just here for four. Hands can come in front or to the hips if that's easier. Nice. Breathing three. Last two. And one. Let those toes come back to the back, but keep that hinge in your body. From here, your body is going to hinge from the hips, lowering the chest towards the ground. Then lift the body up. Again, hinge at the hips, lower the chest towards your mat. And up. If you can, bring those hands in front. We lower the chest. All of the weight should be into that left heel. Two more. Last one. Come all the way into that nice diagonal line. If you can, lift the back leg off the mat. Hands out nice and long. Shoulders relaxed. We're holding 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Release. Give that left leg a shake out. Other side, and then we're all warmed up. You'll be pleased to know. Warm up, yes, that's right. All right, right leg forward. Again, taking that sink first, we're just gonna take the lunges. So body's nice and long, lower, and lift. Take this moment to regain your breath. Nice deep inhales through the nose, exhales through the mouth. Can't hear my fellow friends here breathing. So hopefully you guys at home are. All right, last one. Come up, hinge the body forward, keep that back leg back, left toes are back. Think about your hips, head like to the car pointing towards the mat. We tap the left foot forward and back. Nice. Really sink that body weight into your right heel this time. If you want to, bring those hands out in front of you and line framing your ears. Now, taking that other option, harder option if you want. Knee drives up, the leg comes back, it doesn't touch the mat. So more into the balance here, warming up that glute into the right side. Hands can be on your hips. 3. Last 2, sink a little lower into that right leg. Hinge that body forward. Last 1. Reach that left leg out, let the toes touch the mat slightly, bring the hands up, you're going to hinge your body forward. So hinging from the hips, you draw the body weight down towards the mat, then lift all the way into that diagonal. Hinge the body forward, and up. 2 more. Last 1, hinging forward, bring that body into the diagonal, lift that back leg if you can. Sink a little lower into the right leg. Holding. 4, 3. Last 2, and 1. Shake it out. Nice. Take a drink of water. And we're going to come down and sit on the mat. Hope you're all going okay. Hi, Cole. Hi, Em. Hi, Lucy. All right, guys. Down onto the mat. Okay. I said we were gonna do that one that was in my picture on Instagram, so that's what we're gonna do right now. It's called a roll up. So you want your heels to be right at the front of your mat, so you've got a nice bit of space behind you. Hands are gonna come out in front. Shoulders are in line with your fingertips. Palms facing each other. Roll into the lower spine. Lower all the way down onto your mat. Bone by bone, head comes down. Hands draw overhead. Then reach your hands up to the ceiling, chin comes to the chest. Peel your spine off the mat, bone by bone. Draw the belly button in towards your spine, then reach all the way forward to your toes. Again, let's go, rolling ourselves back. Come up to that nice seated position, then roll into the lower spine first. Rolling your spine back onto the mat, bone by bone. Once your shoulder blades hit, your head lowers, hands come back over your head. Reach your hands to the ceiling, chin comes to chest, peel your spine off the mat, bone by bone, really slowly drive your hands forward to your heels. One more time, rolling the spine back. Nice. Really slowly moving through the spine here, guys. Nice. You're gonna stay lying down this time, hands come down by your side. Perfect. And then from here, you're gonna bring your legs into a tabletop position. Right? So your legs are in tabletop. Both of your hands are gonna place into your thighs. Press your hands as hard as you can into each thigh bone. We're just gonna hold here. Heads down on the mat. I really want you to fight your palm into your thigh into your palm. As we here, start thinking about your breath. You should already feel the shakes here. Inhaling through your nose. Exhaling through your mouth. 2 more breaths. Inhaling. And exhaling. 1 more breath. Press as hard as you can.
your next exhale, crunch your head up and hold here. Your left foot is going to extend out, your palm goes with it. So you extend one leg out, then draw all the way back into center. Right leg presses out, draws back into center. Okay, so keep moving through alternative legs. As you do so, that other palm is pressing as hard as it can into the other thigh. Really move slowly here. If you need to lower the head down to the mat, remove that crunch. Draw your belly button down to your spine. Keep thinking about that breath you just had before. Let's go for four. Last three. Last two. On one, come back into the center, hold that press. Both palms pressing into your thighs. Can you crunch a little higher? Pressing, pressing, pressing. Should have some shakes. Crunch a little higher, get those shoulders off the ground. Five, four, three, two, one. Hug the knees into the chest. Tiny breather. All right, your hands are gonna come nice and long. Your legs are going to come into a tabletop position, glue the thighs and toes together. All right, we did this before in our first class. You're going to lift the palms off the mat, crunch your head and shoulders up, eye gazes to your knees. All right, we're in our hundredth, pulsing those hands. Inhale, two, three, four, five. Exhale, two, three, four, five. Keep pulsing the hands. I'm going to cue you through some progressions here. So you can stay pulsing with your knees in that tabletop position. We're at 30, inhale, two, three, four, five. Exhale, two, three, four, five. Inhale, two, three, four, five. Exhale, two, three, four, five. Halfway. If you want to now, take the legs and extend them long into a nice 45 degree angle. Keep pulsing those hands. Draw the belly button down to your spine. Inhale, two, three, four, five. Exhale, two, three, four, five. 30 to go. Pulse those hands, draw the belly button in. Keep breathing. 20. Keep pulsing. Last 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Hug the knees to chest. Roll it out. All right, couple more challenges for the core. This time I want you to keep your head back on the mat. So you're like lying nice and long, palms facing, pressing into the mat. And I want you in a little neutral spine position. So a little pocket of air underneath your lower spine. You should be able to put your fingertips through there. All right, slowing down the breath. Bring both of your legs up on top of your hip bones. So they're nice and long and straight. Perfect. From here, you're going to flutter kick the legs. So crisscross them over. And as you do so, lower them slightly towards the mat. Once you hit a point, you feel your spine moving. Flutter them all the way back up above your hips. Okay, so the movement's coming down and up with the legs. You're just crisscrossing those ankles over each other. Think about keeping your spine still. Press those palms into the mat. Two more. Traveling down and up. If you want a little bit more for your last one, crunch your hip up. Cross those legs down. Keep breathing here. All right, final one. Lowering the legs down and all the way up. Hold the legs nice and high. Press those hands in to the ground. Your left leg is going to stay where it is. Your right leg's going to open out to the side of the room. And then draw all the way back into center. Same side. Right leg opens out. It draws all the way back in. So we're warming up those inner thighs now while we're still working the core. As you open up that right leg, try to not let your left hip draw off the mat. Two more. Keep breathing. One more on that side. The leg comes up to meet the left. Left leg goes. Left leg opens to the left-hand side. Comes back into center. Hips are staying heavy onto that mat, okay? We want our tailbones heavy. No movement through the hips. Just opening that left leg out and to the middle. more. Last one. Both legs come into the center. Final challenge here. You want your feet still stacked above your hip bones this time. Both legs open out to the side into a split. You draw the legs together. Open out, exhale. Inhale, zip the legs together. Nice. Exhale, open the legs out. Inhale, zip them together. Let's go for two more, working those inner thighs, our glutes and our abs. Last one, open out. Can we hold here a little? Can you stretch the split a little deeper? Three, two, one. Draw the legs together. Hug the knees to chest. Roll it up. Nice. All right. Should be feeling warm. Should feel that core all warmed up now. Take a drink of water if you need to. All right. We're going to need to use that towel or that cushion now. So just get that nice and handy and close to you. All right. I'm just going to move the mat so you guys can see a bit more clearly with this one. So I'm facing you. Okay, you're gonna bring that cushion or towel, whatever you've got, and place it in between your knees. You're gonna be kneeling on your mat in a high kneeling position facing me. If you do get sore knees and you're on a hard surface here, you can cross your mat over so you've got double thickness. See how you go. All right, from there, I want you to bring your left hand and place it down on the mat. So you're gonna be in a weird hinge for now. Cool, and we're just gonna stretch it out to start. Right hand stretches over the body. Should feel a nice stretch to that right side. And come back up, other side. One more on each direction, slow down that breath. And release. All right, shuffle slightly more over to the side. Keep that towel where it is. Your left elbow or forearm is going to come down on the mat. Cool. You want a nice long body through the side. So through your left side, think about really lifting and wrapping those obliques around your body. This hand comes up onto the top of your hip. All right, for now, all I want you to do is squeeze that towel or cushion and release. So it's not going to look much on my camera. I just want you to think about gluing those thighs together and releasing. Really squeeze that towel or cushion as we activate those inner thighs. You think it's doing nothing, but I promise you it is. Really squeeze that towel and keep that lift through your side body. Nice. We're just here for five, four, three, two, and one. Take that towel cushion, place it in front of you, and lengthen your legs out nice and long. So you stay up on this left forearm, your legs are nice and long. Your left leg is gonna stay long, your right knee is gonna cross over and plant in front of your foot. In front of your left leg, sorry. All right, so you should still feel that nice wrapping of the core that lifts through your left side. All I want you to do is lift up that bottom leg and draw it back down to the mat. Nice. So you're lifting and lowering. Lift, lower. Nice. That's all we're doing. As we're here, I want you to focus on your hips, not rolling back or forward. Okay? So they're stacked on top of each other. You've got a bony left hip. You should start to feel it digging into the ground. Lift and lower. Try not to let yourself sink into your left shoulder. Really push your elbow into the mat. Draw your ribs up. Nice. Five, four, three, last two, and one. Grab that towel or cushion and lie on your back. This time the cushion is going to come in between your thighs again. So you just want it between your hips and your knees, okay? Right in the inner thigh, give it a nice tight squeeze. You're in your glute bridge position, so about a hand distance between your heel and your bum. Head's nice and low on the mat. We've you've done this before, in our glute bridge position. I want you to just peel those hips off the mat, lift the hips nice and high. Once you're there, give that cushion a nice squeeze, twice, then lower the hips down to the ground. Don't let the bum touch the mat. Lift up, squeeze into the glutes, hips come high, squeeze that cushion twice, hinge the hips, lower the bum, it hovers off the mat. Lift, press into that towel, lower the hips. Nice, so just keep moving through this. Give me two or three pulses at the top before you crease at the hips to lower the bum to halfway. Squeezing into that towel or cushion. Let's go for five more here. If you want to make this a little harder, you can bring your hands, reach them up above your shoulders. Nice, let's go for three more. Squeeze that towel or cushion, imagine you're trying to break it. Your inner thigh should be starting to feel a little warm now. Maybe you're feeling it more into your glutes. Everything's good. Two more. If you didn't know, Pilates teachers can't count. Last one. Hold, squeeze. Let's go for eight, seven. Hips are nice and level. Imagine you're balancing some very prized Easter eggs on those hips. Four, three, last two, and one. Drop the hips down. Come onto your tiptoes. Lift the heels off the mat. Exactly the same sequence. You're gonna hinge the hips up. Squeeze into the glutes, then squeeze that cushion twice at the top. Crease at the hips, lower the bum to hover off the mat. The heels do not come down. We come back up, squeeze, and lower. So it's exactly the same movement as before. You're creasing at the hips to lower the bum to hover off the mat. Then pressing the hips up, squeezing that cushion. Nice, think about your knees pressing up over your middle toes. Reach those knees as far as you can. Should be feeling nice and warm now. Keep thinking about that breath. If you need your hands down on the mat, use the palms to help you here. Let's go for four more. Last three. Last two. Last one, hold. Hold those heels nice and high. Final squeezes, squeeze that towel or cushion. Eight, seven, six, five, four, three, last two, and one. Come all the way down. Place that cushion or towel to the side and set yourself up. Should we bring Ben in now? I reckon we should. Who's keen?
Probably
not. We're going to do that on the other side. So Ben, come on over. Getting some new fans over here. All right. So Ben's going to demo and I'm going to cue him through. All right. So this time you're going to be on your right forearm. So your right forearm is going to be down on the mat. Nice. You're going to start with the cushion in between your knees. Your knees are going to be bent. So knees are bent towards me. Nice. So you're in this position here, Ben's really demoing nicely. Hips are stacked over each other and I want you to lift through that side, wrap your obliques around, nice. Left hand comes on top of your hip, we're just squeezing that cushion and releasing. Squeezing and releasing, oh this is great. You can just talk, breathe and kill you guys while I'm at it. All right, you've got some fans here, Ben.
Who's that?
Maddie and Lara. Really wanting it. Okay, so I really want you to try and break that cushion. You'll be starting to feel really warm in the inner thighs now. It might seem a little bit more intense than it did on your left side. Keep that nice wrap. We've got four more. Don't let yourself sink into your right shoulder. Last three. Last two. And one, squeeze it, try to break it for me, squeeze it as hard as you can. Five, four, three, two, one. All right, you're gonna take that cushion out, place it in front of you, and lengthen your legs nice and long. Still staying on your side, facing the camera. Nice. So you're still on your forearm. This time your left leg is gonna cross over the front of your right. Perfect, Ben's got that exactly right. Your hip stays
here is use your glutes to help you raise that leg up. I want you to give yourself a little bit of a squeeze as you lift the bottom leg up. Perfect. Try not to sink into that right elbow. Use those core muscles we've been working on so much to hold you up. Let's go for five more. You are a survivor. Three more. Last two. Last one. And release. Lie onto your back. Grab that cushion. Place it in between your knees. Okay, slightly different this time. You're in the same position as a glute bridge, but you're going to come up onto your arms. So I'm about to show you this way. Your hands are going to be behind you, so you're sort of sitting. But your feet are in exactly the same position as you would be in a glute bridge, right? So I don't want too much distance between, about a hand print between your heel and your bum. Nice. With your fingers, fingertips facing your heels. And then your hand is going to be directly under your shoulder, so maybe a little bit more in for you then. Nice. All right, what we're going to do here is we're going to lift the hips or the bum off the mat. Right, nice and high. Perfect. Squeeze that cushion and then lower down. Bum hovers off the mat. Lift up. Squeeze that cushion and lower down. Perfect. So whole body integration here, working into those inner thighs still and the glutes at the same time. As we lift, hips are nice and level, balancing those cocktails. Ben's getting pretty sweaty here, guys. This is brilliant. Four more. Really press into your fingertips. If you need to take a break, do so. Lara's nailing it over here as well, if only you guys could see, and Ellie. Last two. Squeeze that cushion really tight. Last one, I want you to come up and hold. Hips are nice and high. Try to get a bit more height if you can. Squeeze that cushion. Five. Eye gaze to ceiling. Four, three, two, and one. Go all the way down. Take that cushion out.
Lie
onto your back. Ben's had enough, he's going for the day. Bye guys. Okay. All right, I'm back in the game. So I just want you to lie onto your back, hug your knees, take a little bit of a release for that lower spine after that one. Rock from side to side. He didn't even last half a set. Okay, just taking a rock. You can either roll through your spine or just from side to side. All right, hope everyone's feeling good. We're down to 10 minutes to go, good news. All right, we're gonna work into the side body a little bit more now. So you're gonna come up facing the camera into a kneeling position. Nice, so just come into a high kneeling again. Fold that mat over for these sequences if you need to for the knees. Okay, your left hand's gonna come down onto the mat, your right leg's gonna extend out nice and long. So I don't know if you guys can properly see me. Nice. So my toe is nice and pointed on the mat, and I've got my arm underneath my shoulder. So my wrist is underneath my shoulder, wrapping the body up. So hips are still stacked on top of each other. Let's bring that right hand on top of our hips. All right, from here, I just want you to lift and lower that leg. You should already feel it pinching into that right oblique. Nice. So try to keep the shoulders in line. Try not to let your body round forward here. Perfect. Great song. We're here for four. Last three. Squeeze into that left glute. Last two. And one. All right, little release. Okay, if you get a pinch into your left hip flexor, just come up to this position and come back in these ones, all right? Coming back down into that position, exactly the same as before. This time you're gonna bend the knee in, extend the leg out. Right knee bends in, it stretches out. Okay, so keep moving here. Again, if you need to, sit yourself up, reset. Hips are stacked, four, three, last two, and one. Hold here, reach that top hand over. Can you lift the leg up and down? Four, breathing, three, last two, and one. Come into a kneeling position.
position facing the screen. Okay. This time, I want both of your hands to stay behind your head. The leg is going to come out nice and long, but this time you're not going to have the left hand down, okay? So both hands stay behind your head. Fingertips behind your ears. Try not to use your hands to really press into your head. All right. Really pull the elbows back, drop the shoulders down. We're just going to draw the body over. Crunching all the way back up. Inhale. Exhale, draw yourself over. Take an inhale at the bottom. Exhale, round yourself back up. Inhale through the nose. Exhale, round yourself over. Really reach as you hinge. And come back up. Two more. Nice. Last one. Come all the way up to the top. Hold. This time, you're going to hinge. Rotate towards your mat. Draw back to the camera and lift. Reaching out, rotating to mat, rotating up and down. Let's just take two more. Breathe through it. Really hard for me to say breathe through it when I have to talk. One more. Round. Stay here. Round to the mat. Two more times. Round. Last one. You're out of there. Shake it out. Nice work, guys. Okay, we're going to do it straight away on the other side. All right. So this time, right hand comes down on the mat. Your left leg comes out. So think about that setup first. You really want your palm to be underneath your shoulder. Left leg is nice and long. Left hand is on top of your hip. Your hips aren't rounding forward or back. Perfect. From here, lift and lower that left leg. So it's not about height here. I don't want you to bring your foot higher than your hip. We're working into that left glute as well as into our side body. Nice. Three more. Keep breathing here. I'm not going to come up in the middle. So if you need to, just take that break. Last one. Hold the leg high, it bends in, it extends. You should start to feel that right glute a little bit more in this one. Four. Three. Last two. Last one, extend long, lift and lower. Don't let it touch the mat. Five. Four. Three. Two. And one. Come all the way up. Should be feeling nice and sore now, hopefully, guys. All right, so this time, the hand's gonna come down. Sorry, your hand's gonna come behind your head, but your left leg is gonna come out to the side. Cool. So you've got a nice long body. The fingertips are behind the ears. Keep that left leg nice and long. Draw over to the side. And crunch yourself back up. Inhale, exhale to lower. Inhale, hold. Exhale, bring yourself all the way back up. As you draw over, really think about reaching your body out before you hinge to the mat. Two more. And then we're going to add that rotation. Nice. Last one. Come all the way up and hold. Adding rotation, drawing down. Rotate your body to face the mat. Rotate to face the camera. And up. Rotate down. Round. Out. And up. Let's go for two more. Keep thinking about that breath for me. That nice long reach with your body. Last one. Come here. Hold. Rotate. Center. Rotate. Center. Let's go for two more. Last one. Come all the way up. All right. Moving to one last challenge and then we're stretching. So you should be feeling nice and warm now, guys. Side body's worked. We're just going to do some mountain climber plank work to finish as a little kicker and then we're stretching. Hands come underneath
incline, eye gaze comes to the front of the mat. Your right leg is going to draw towards your left elbow. It stays forward as it comes to your right elbow. It then goes to your left elbow and comes back. Left side, left goes to the right elbow. It crosses back to left, opposite, and release. So you get it, it's 3 points. 3, 2, 1, release. 3, 2, 1, release. 3, 2, 1, release. All right, keep moving here. If you can speed it up, do so. Eye gaze forward. We're just gonna be here for 5 more. Then I promise we're stretching. You can go and eat your dinner. I can have some lunch. All right, 4. Keep breathing. 3. Eye gaze forward, last 2. Last 1. Nice. Knees come down, butt sinks back. Child's pose, stretch those fingertips nice and long. Reach those fingers nice and long. I'm gonna get some slower tunes on. Nice deep breath in. This is a good one. All right. Left leg comes out in front. We're gonna work into a mermaid position. If you've ever done this in a reform with me, right leg's back, parallel. Okay, perfect. Yep, so your left leg's in front. Left hand comes onto the ground. We're just gonna stretch at that side, but you really reach over. Feel a nice stretch to the right side of your body. And then come back, switching sides. Really slow down the breath now. Try to keep your hip bones heavy, pelvis heavy into the mat here. One more on the side. Reaching over, trying to flip your body round. One more. And then just switch the legs out. So your right foot comes forward. Nice. Right hand comes down, reach over. Feel that stretch through your left side. And release more. Nice, 2 more. Slow down the breath. Breathe in all that oxygen. I think you've successfully burnt off at least 3 hot crisp buns, if that makes you feel better. All right, shake those shoulders out. We're just gonna stretch out the hip flexors now. Your left leg's gonna come forward. Reach your right leg. Hips forward. So your left leg stays in that nice straight line. You can see in the camera right there over the heel, but press your hips forward until you feel a stretch to the front of your right thigh. Nice. Left hand comes onto your left knee and then just reach over, feeling that stretch to your side. One more deep inhale. Exhale, coming back. Let's switch. Right leg comes forward. Sorry, Mum, we've been on your knees a lot. All right, hinge that body forward. If you want to take that side stretch, right hand's on the knee, and then reach the left arm over. Nice deep inhale. And exhale. Releasing all the way off. Sit down on your mat. Bring the inner parts of your feet together. Let's just stretch those inner thighs a bit. Hands come onto the feet. Butterfly pose. Nice. Press those knees towards the mat. If you want to, close your eyes here. Take those nice deep inhales through your nose. Exhaling through your mouth. Imagine you're blowing out a candle as you breathe out. Press those knees a little deeper towards the mat. One more. Inhaling through the nose. Exhaling through the mouth. Well done, guys, you're all finished. Go and enjoy the rest of your long weekend. If you're at home, have a great day. See you later. Bye.